This is your Barbados Today Morning News Update for Wednesday, May 29, 2019. Thanks for joining us. I'm Carol Williams. Government is now moving to put in place a cap on the garbage and sewage contribution levy. This after numerous complaints, particularly from farmers, about the effect on their water bills. Minister of Water Resources Wilfred Abrams announced the move in the House last evening during debate on the Utilities Amendment Bill.
So people should not be disadvantaged from accessing a water supply and being able to pay for it where the circumstances indicate that such is just and equitable. And all that happens, sir, is that we shoot ourselves in the foot. The Barbados Water Authority does not connect the people, and the people go and connect themselves illegally in any event, so they contribute to the non-revenue water. So I can assure the honorable member that that will be engaging the attention of the cabinet and the parliament of Barbados, I would say, within the next 8 weeks. So you can tell, all the members can tell their constituents to look out for it. It is something that we have on the front burner, and we're trying to nail it down, but it will be addressed in exceedingly short order.
The Utilities Amendment Bill facilitates an adjustment to the water rate for businesses. It was reported that the BWA is owed some $60 million, a large amount of which is owed by commercial entities. And one entity that will be further affected by the change to the commercial water rate is the Nature Fund Ranch, which is reporting it's already under pressure. The Bruceville St. Andrew facility that caters to at-risk youth is $25,000 in debt to the BWA. Founder Corey Lane says they arrived at the facility yesterday to find a padlock had been placed on the water main. He explains that while they've been using conservation methods, water to the ranch was initially attached to a pipe linked to the former sugar factory, and that bill had been transferred to theirs. He's appealing to the public for help.
Recently, when the bill really reached a part where I would tell you that the Nature Fund Ranch was unable to pay, when it started to claim, I was able to have, be fortunate to have a meeting with the Barbados Water Authority chairman, manager, and the minister responsible for waterworks, and they did make an arrangement, so I want to be fair with them. Now, of course, we at Nature Fund Ranch understand that we may not be as privileged to have the facilities afforded to us like what happened recently, according to reports in Westmoreland, where they were not built for 15 years and that was able to be waived, or be fortunate, like the prison and the hotel, not to be cut off, because what they do is critical to Barbados. What we do may be critical as well. And I think that today we have a course on, we have animals to feed, and the guys are graduating from a three-month chef course. And this morning we came and we found a lock on the pipe, now where we have no potable water on site.
2 months, that's the timeline set for a permanent solution to the problem of Barbadians living on property for which they don't have title deeds, being unable to legally access water from the BWA. Minister Wilfred Abrams informed the House last night that legislation is coming to regularize the situation.
We accept that some people may be disadvantaged because of the increased rates, some people whose return, they can't manage to recover those input costs, and this would largely include farmers. So we're looking at a cap on the GSC, the levy. We would not necessarily be able to adjust the water rate or make a compromise on the water rate for them, but we're looking at finding a cap for the GSC that would be a bit more equitable to those who have to use a certain amount of water and don't have a discretion in it, that they have no way of reducing it because that is the necessary input and is input at a certain quantity. So that is one of the things we're looking at. Once we balance, we're going to have to look at as well what comes in now as a result of this increase. When we have maybe 1 or 2 months figures on that, we'll be in a better position to figure out what the cap is going to be.
And still with Parliament, the House has rejected an amendment made in the Senate to the Public Service Retrenched Workers Bill. It was announced last night by Minister in the Ministry of Finance, Ryan Strachan.
The substantive matter here relates to the fact that the amendment spoke to the inclusion of both pension and gratuity, payment of pension and gratuity with respect to the amendment of the bill. And so therefore, the amendments made by the Honourable Senate sought to separate the fact that in the legislation it speaks already to the payment of both gratuity and pension, and to the extent that the clauses in the bill spoke to the fact that those retrenched workers at the Ministry of Transport, Works and Maintenance will be paid their gratuity, but the pension will be paid upon attaining the pensionable age, which is normal procedure, sir, that the amendments that was made in the Senate, the House is not in agreement with.
On to other news, Prime Minister Mia Mottley has been remembering former Jamaica Prime Minister Edward Seaga, who passed away yesterday on his 89th birthday.
Mr. Seaga's career reflects a man that appreciated the critical importance of the development of institutions and infrastructure, especially as you set out to build a new nation. He will forever be remembered for this clear commitment to building these institutions and infrastructure, not just in Jamaica, but across the entire Caribbean. I last saw Mr. Seaga in January of this year when we both attended the 50th anniversary of the Jamaica Stock Exchange earlier in Kingston. There, he participated in a distinguished panel of three former Jamaican prime ministers. But what was particularly noticeable to me was not just his general incisive commentary on the development path of what Jamaica needed to do to sustain itself, particularly through agriculture, but was his comment and his insistence that, in his frank observation, trickle-down economics has not worked. To the very end, Mr. Seaga was insistent on sharing his perspective. The region will therefore miss his thoughtful commentary on matters of importance to its people.
There's regional and international news after this short break.
Barbados Today, news you can trust.
In the Bahamas, the doctors' union is threatening strike action. Members are claiming the Public Hospitals Authority is refusing to honor the industrial agreement. We get more from Eyewitness News.
Months after the Bahamas Doctors Union agreed to call off strike action over outstanding holiday pay, the junior doctors are once again threatening to withdraw their services. This time, the doctors claim the Public Hospitals Authority has reduced employee contracts from 3 years to 1 year without consultation with the union and without thinking of how the move affects doctors' everyday lives. BDU President Dr. Melisande Bassett said enough is enough.
This union has not been told or informed of the government's intent to implement one-year contracts. It just started to happen and slowly seeping into our everyday work practice. This isn't legal. We will use all of the, and again, I say this, all of the legal means. If it means that we have to take strike action, then we will. We will continue to dialogue with the minister and the Department of Health and PHA to ensure that this issue is resolved and ensure that our members have some job security.
And finally, Europe's most powerful leaders were on a collision course over filling Brussels' top job as they gathered for a summit in the wake of elections that shook up traditional alliances. The EU's 28 national leaders are deciding who will succeed Jean-Claude Juncker as head of the European Commission, the bloc's powerful executive. And that's news, but for the very latest, visit our website at www.barbadostoday.bb. You can also subscribe to our e-paper, email updates, or like us on Facebook. And sign up for breaking news alerts via WhatsApp. We're also on Izumi Media in bus terminals, as well as Screenplay at supermarkets and gas stations near you. You can also hear us on Mix 96.9 FM and Capital Media HD 99.3 FM. I'm Carol Williams. Have a good day.